ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports, is at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. It's round 22 of 25 of the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. Tonight, it's the Orleans 250. The championship points chase is still within reach for Jack Sprague, Dennis Setzer, and Stacy Compton, but they have got to stop Greg Biffle. He has won 8 races this year. He leads Sprague by 125 points. Trucks are already out on the racetrack, taking the warm-up laps. Let's take a look at our Mopar starting grid. Stacy Compton on the pole, his sixth of 1999. Mike Bliss alongside, the third year in a row he has started there. Randy Renfro in the fourth spot, very good. Our points leader, Greg Biffle, will start fifth.
Back in 11th spot, Jamie McMurray out of the Remax Challenge Series, the biggest racetrack he's ever competed on. And Brendan Gaughan from Las Vegas starting in 12th.
Further down into the field, Randy Tolles was starting in the 17th position. They had a broken shock. Expect him to move forward through the pack. Also, in the number 66, the 23rd position, Mike Stefanik. Last year, he made his Craftsman Truck debut here, and he came home in 8th position. There you see the rest of our starting field as they make their way onto the backstretch here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway.
Take a look at our onboard cameras. That's Mike Wallace. What a great shot. Team ASC Ford. Looking back at the driver, Andy Houston, the Cat Team Rental Chevrolet. And Ron Hornaday, the Napa Chevrolet. Hornaday starts in 7th position. Jack Sprague, as he tries to catch Greg Biffle, starts in 6th spot. The GMAC Chevrolet. There's the Granger Ford of Greg Biffle. He will be starting 5th. Joe Ruttman, the Dana Dodge. Ruttman starts in 3rd position. And we also have an onboard camera along on our pole sitter, Stacy Compton, the Royal Crown Dodge.
So the pace truck makes his way into turn number 4. Wait for him to pull in. Here's the race analysis. And look at the bottom there. Ford can clinch its first ever NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series manufacturer title by finishing any position ahead of a Chevrolet. Round 22 makes its way towards the starting line. The green flag flies, and we are underway. Sun's going to play havoc here about for the next 30 minutes. Down the back straightaway. It looks like we're going to try doing this 3 and 4 wide, Benny.
There's 3 wide as Jimmy Hendrick goes on the inside. See, Mike Bliss is taking the lead from the pole sitter, from his outside pole sitter, comes by, tries to lead that first lap.
We've got a black flag. They are waving the black flag. Did they wave that at Bliss? The 41 is what we're being told. Randy Renfro does not have a radio.
Joe's outside.
On board right now with Greg Biffle.
And the caution flag is out.
Got a truck smoking down the back straightaway. It looks like it's the 46 of Rob Morgan.
What a huge, huge break for the 41 truck of Randy Tolsma.
So there you see Rob Morgan making his way. It looks like the motor has let go on the Axiom Ford. There you see Randy Renfro making his way down pit lane. Dave, give us an update.
Well, Marty, what a huge break for Randy Renfro and this Mike Ferris-owned team. He did not have the radio. Todd Myers, the crew chief, is now going to pull down the window net and insert the radio into its slot there. They're going to top it off with fuel as well. And once they get him hooked up again, Randy will have communication. They talked about, you know, what was going on. They couldn't talk back and forth, and the NASCAR official just asked him straight out, "Do you guys have a radio?" And he said, "No." And NASCAR had to black flag him and bring him in.
Terry Cook making his way back out onto the racetrack after an unscheduled stop. Terry had a little contact with a spin yesterday in the last practice session, made it into the field on a provisional. It's not been one of the better weekends for Terry. But so far, it's been a great day for Mike Bliss. Take a look. Coming into this race, Jack Sprague led Mike Bliss by 4 laps in the total laps led here at Las Vegas. And as far as that point is now, it's a dead heat because we have completed 4 laps, and Mike Bliss has led all 4 of them. The word we're getting on Rob Morgan, the reason we're under this first caution, he lost the transmission. So we are about ready to go back to green flag racing, and we are underway.
And And Joe Rubin's truck is not getting up to speed. The Dana Dodge is right in the middle of the racetrack. Truck's going by right and left. Now it looks like he finally gets back up to speed.
Did he miss a gear, Ben?
That's what it looks like.
Yes, sir. We have plenty of
on board with Rutman. That's the Orleans Chevrolet of Brendan Gaughan right in front of him. Brendan's going to start on the pole for tomorrow's Winston West race. Here comes Mike Bliss. Boy, it looks like the Exide 4 doing well. And also, Jack Sprague has moved into third position. He's got a lot of pressure on Stacy Compton.
And we've got a spinner. John Young, the 72 car, is spun and is sitting up in turn four. Is the caution flag going to come out? Yes, it is.
So quickly, we have had our second caution of the night. Now, John gets it refired. He does have some contact with the wall. You can see the left rear of the truck is pretty well mangled, and he dives into the pit lane, but we will go for our second caution here on lap number seven.
John Young trying to break into oval track racing. And never see the 41 car of Randy Renfro, and then we see John Young in the 72 going up and making contact with the wall.
Upper left, keep your eye. There he goes. Yeah, he got up in the gray.
He just got a little bit too high. And here's, that CMP on the quarter panel is John Young's company that he owns.
Marty, another thing that his competitors don't want to hear is that Greg hasn't touched the truck much since they brought it off it for practice to begin with. They haven't changed hardly a thing. And last night, during happy hour, they covered it up early. And crew chiefs like Steve Beal of the 16 truck noticed that. And they said, that's the biggest thing we learned in happy hour is Biffle covered up early, and they're going to be good. Quick update on Biffle, though. They had little contact with Joe Rutman's truck, and they also got the window dirtied up from the oil dry that was put down after Rob Morgan's truck laid down the motor. So they've got a dirty windshield and a little bit of damage on the left front fender.
And he's currently running in sixth position. And look at this. It is nose to tail for all six spots. Bliss up front. Then it's Compton. Jack Sprague is in third. Then fourth is Ron Hornaday, Andy Houston, and Green Biffle. That's your top six, and you're on board with Houston.
And Houston on the inside. Now we see a battle for the lead as Stacy Compton goes on the inside of Mike Bliss. Meanwhile, a battle for fourth position between Andy Houston and the 16 of Hornaday.
And while all this action is going on, here comes Compton, still looking for victory number one in 1999, and he retakes the lead on the bottom of the racetrack. And here comes Jack Sprague, and three wide and behind him. Hold on, guys. Here we go. Through the tri-oval. Who's got the lead at the end of the lap? It's going to be Sprague. Andy Houston in fourth. Here comes Bliss trying to go back around. Stacy Compton, don't take your eyes away to eat any popcorn. You're going to miss a pass.
And Andy Houston trying to get on the inside of Stacy Compton. That's the battle for the third position.
Houston's underneath him. Hornaday's going to try and go on the high side.
And here comes Jimmy Hinsman on the outside of Greg Biffle.
All of this action going on in the top seven positions. Oh, Andy Houston gets turned around sideways. Can he save it?
Oh, my goodness. No, just touches Joe Rutman.
No yellow yet.
The contact with... Oh, and what a great escape there by one truck. Could not get a number on it. Houston had almost made the save.
That was... I thought he was going to save the vehicle.
The left front.
Unbelievable. And just the last second contact with Joe Rutman caused the truck to spin.
There is no caution on the racetrack because Andy has got damage to the left front, but it looks like he's going to be able to get to the pit lane as we're on board. And as he comes around, we should point out Father Tommy was in his backup truck in the number six. In fact, they're going to keep him out there. He comes across the line. He's dropped well back to 31st position. Back to the battle up front. There's Jack Sprague in front of Mike Bliss. Let's go back and take another look, BP.
Look at Greg Biffle on the inside. As the 60 truck spins, and Biffle and Hornaday are so close to that crash, and never see Joe Rutman come along and just that little bit of contact causes the 60 truck to spin of Andy Houston.
And all of these trucks, boy, look at the evasive action taken by everybody to avoid colliding with Andy Houston. Now, Bliss has got pressure on Jack Sprague. Houston, we'll tell you, is staying out on the racetrack. Rob Morgan has also made it back out on the racetrack, so they fixed the transmission leak in the Axiom 4. Through turns 1 and 2, boy, Bliss has got that Exide 4 glued to the bottom.
Really does.
Sprague owns the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series record for 9 super speedway wins in his career. And he owns this racetrack. He sat on the pole twice. He's won 2 of the 3 prior races. Joe Rutman is the other winner. And they already know about what happened here last year with that great finish. Sprague first, Hornaday second. And there is Joe Rutman into the pits. Amy.
He was definitely part of that altercation with Andy Houston, so they elected to bring him in and tear away the sheet metal on the right rear, which was affected with that contact with the 60 truck. Give him some tires. They're now signaling the crew for some more help, and they told Joe, you better get back out there. We don't want to lose time in the pits.
Cindy, this is George.
Well, Joe is one of those guys. He really knows when to lead. Let's go back on board for a second with Andy Houston and watch what happens.
This is a team, Cat Reynolds, and never seen just a little bit of wiggle down in the corner, getting in the corner, and around he goes, and there we see the contact with the Dana Dodge of Joe Rutman. Man. Andy Houston was so pumped up about the race tonight. Thought he had an excellent chance to win.
Looking a little bit further back, Brendan Gaughan seems to be in trouble. He is slowing. He had been running up into the top 10. And all of a sudden, the Orleans Chevrolet has slowed up and is falling back. Currently shown in 11th position, but Jamie McMurray has gotten around him, so that's going to bump him back a little bit further.
Sean, don't be hitting him.
Now it looks like he's back up to speed.
Okay.
There you see McMurray and B.A. Wilson right in front of him. So, in fact, Gaughan has dropped all the way back to 15th position, BP. And now we go back up front. Leader Jack Sprague putting a lap on the number 46 of Rob Morgan. And there is Andy Houston, aerodynamically unsound. You're riding on board with Jack Sprague. And now we've got a battle for second brewing, as it is Bliss and Biffle. And Biffle's gotten around his Killer B teammate.
Well, much of a battle to it. Actually, just drove on the inside of Bliss down in 1 and 2 and took the spot away. We can see that Biffle is running a much lower line through the corner than is Mike Bliss. And here comes Hornaday, the Napa Chevrolet, to challenge Mike Bliss.
So Hornaday looking to break an 18-race string where he has been winless. We're on board with the Napa Chevrolet. His last time out was his best run in a long time. He came home in second place. Behind the wall, the Dana Dodge of Joe Rutman. Amy?
We were going to talk to Joe Rutman, but then he fired up the truck and they were going to send him back out. But the right rear sheet metal damage was so extensive that they decided to bring him in. Thinking about jumping in here, but he's put the cage net back up and it looks like he's going to be getting ready to go back out. When I talked to him briefly, he said he had no place to go. Houston just clipped that right rear. It was enough to send him in. His team wants to get him back out.
Battle for the lead going with Greg Biffle and Jack Sprague. Remember, these two got together late in the race last year here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. You're on board with Biffle. Look at the speeds. Biffle definitely quicker.
But unfortunately, right now, the 24 truck is running the same exact spot that Greg Biffle wants to
really
run.
Really tight behind him.
What'd he say?
I don't know. I got
it. Said,
player.
And we see that Hornaday is going by Mike Bliss to take over the third spot. He said, I think he said the truck was not handling properly behind the 24 truck of Sprague.
Hornaday has definitely gotten around Bliss for third, and you saw from the onboard shot the sun that these guys are looking into when they come out of turn 4, and it is blinding. Napa Field summary in the upper left-hand portion of your screen, checking the points. No major changes in the top 5, but look at Hornaday. He would jump up 2 spots if the race ended right now.
And Andy Houston would be the big loser, losing 3 positions.
Further down the line, there is Joe Rutman back out onto the racetrack, but he is obviously several laps down. the sun will be a factor for about another 15 to 20 minutes, and then we will be into sunset. And Brendan Gaughan, the Orleans Chevrolet, a lot of smoke the last lap. They are sending him back out, but he has dropped well off the pace. In fact, he is shown in 30th position right now. There is Rick McRae, the Lucas Oil Chevrolet. He is being put a lap down. They've been in and out of the pits several times. Rick was able to stay on the lead lap until just then, Benny.
And now, all of a sudden, Biffle is losing ground to the leader of the race, Jack Sprague.
Take a look. Here's first and second. After nine races this year on the super speedways, the average finish, Greg Biffle, 5.2, 6.7 for Sprague.
And there's Hornaday on the inside, taking the spot away from Greg Biffle, moving into second spot.
On board with Hornaday. You can see the adjustment he's got to make coming from the sunshine into the shade. There's Ruttman in between the two Roush Racing teammates.
Yeah, just a little bit too free. Just a little bit too free.
That's Greg Biffle telling Randy Gossett and crew that the truck right now is too loose.
Yeah, but Benny and the guys in happy hour last night were saying the more the sun went down, the more the track tightened up.
Well, that should happen as it gets cooler, as the night wears on. It should.
Joe's right underneath your rear wing.
Eight laps down, Joe. Talking about the rear wing, and that's Goss letting him know that Ruttman is eight laps down.
He's got a two-wreck there, so just watch him, though.
Goss giving the cue to his driver there as far as what Ruttman's position was. Goss joins Rich Versus as the only crew chief to score eight victories in a single NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series season.
Rich Versus now moved on over to the Dale Earnhardt GM Goodrich Chevrolet on the NASCAR Winston Cup circuit.
And Burgess did that when he was crew chief for Mike Skinner. There is Mike Bliss. Still all the talk about him going to the 30 car with his old crew chief, Barry Dodson. Talked to Mike, and he said, well, the buyout clause has been reduced, but it still isn't a done deal. So as of right now, he's still under contract for next year with the number 99.
Right now, Mike Bliss is fighting a tight condition coming off of turn four and in the middle of one and two. They've radioed back and forth, and he and Matt Chambers, the crew chief, have decided to just ride it out for right now, mainly because they don't know exactly where the track is going to end up when that sun has been down for a few more minutes. So right now, they're just waiting, living with a tight condition.
He's still going around a lot of the other trucks that are having a lot more problems than the XI4.
Stacy Compton has done nothing but start off the season very tough, but has yet to score that first win. This team wants the win and knows that they have a chance here at Vegas. Well, Stacy Compton is currently running fifth, and with another pole position, Kevin Cram said that they'll do everything possible to make sure Stacy is out front. Right now, the truck is a slight bit tight, but again, they don't know what the track will do as the sun sets here in Vegas.
Yeah, he's 8.3 seconds behind the race leader, which is now Ron Hornaday. And there he is while we were in commercial break. Hornaday got around Jack Sprague. And this is deja vu for us. I mean, we expected these two to duke it out all season long, but it's been a long time since Hornaday and Sprague have been 1-2. Let's go back and take you through the pass.
Going in turn three, Jack Sprague backs off because the Ford truck of Austin Cameron is up there. And when he backed off, Hornaday just drove that Napa Chevrolet on the inside that took the lead.
Back on board with Ron Hornaday.
Right now, they have about a 2.5-second lead on Mike Bliss and almost a 3-second lead on Greg Biffle, the fourth-place truck. And Stacy Compton is even about 5 or 6 seconds behind the lead. Oh, I'm sorry, Compton is almost 10 seconds behind the leader.
There is Mike Bliss, currently shown in third position. Hornaday, our race leader. Do you believe this? If I told you the last time Ron Hornaday led the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series race was back in early August when we were at Indianapolis Raceway Park. Would you believe that?
No, I wouldn't.
It is the truth.
Wow. Saw Randy Renfro about to go a lap down, getting very, very loose in front of Hornaday, the leader.
We're on board with Jack Sprague, and you're right. Boy, there he goes up the hill. Both Hornaday and Sprague get underneath Renfro. Disappointment for this team because they qualified so well. They came in here fourth. And this has been sort of what deja vu for them in respects because they had good starts, good runs going early at both Michigan and Texas and ended up falling back because of mechanical problems. No problem right now for those two guys, Hornaday and Sprague, with 126 laps to go out of 167, are running lockstep first and second. The lap speed still up over 150 mile an hour average. Give you an idea, our pole, a new record by Compton at 161.803 miles an hour. Down the back straightaway. Guys making their way around the track. That is the 73 of David Starr. Here is the Napa Field summary and the points championship as of right now. And the cameras back to find the 43, the Dodge by Petty of Jimmy Hensley. He has moved himself into sixth position, BP.
Started in 10th spot, but the bad news is he's about 15 seconds behind the leader, Ron Hornaday.
Hensley, of course, out of this ride at the end of the season. No word yet on where he'll be driving next year. He does want to stay in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. Of course, he won at Martinsville earlier this year and was 15th at our last race at Richmond. And Mike Wallace has made his traditional move to the front. Doesn't qualify very well. He was 13th on the grid here, but has moved up now to 7th position, and we're on board the Team ASE 4.
The word down here on pit lane in the two pit is that once again his truck is excellent in turns one and two, and he is scared of it in turns three and four. But Tim Booth does not know what type of adjustment to make. It is a big concern, and Benny, you might be able to add to this as to what this track condition will do when it is the same temperature all the way around. A lot of guessing going on down here in the two pit.
Well, that's exactly right, because as you said, turns one and two is in the shade, three and four, the sun is shining down, and in a few minutes, that will all equal out, and then these guys can make adjustments. They don't want to get too hasty and make big adjustments right now because that second caution flag, they may have to go back where they started.
Well, Mike is only 66 points out of fourth place. He's been making a run. He was seventh just a few races ago. Take a look at his super confidence on the super speedways this year. His average finish in 99, 6.1. That's second in the series. He has six top fives, and he has moved from actually eighth to fifth in the last six races. There you see, we're moving back up front. That is Ron Hornaday, the middle truck in that three truck pack. He's getting ready to put another lap on a slower vehicle, but Jack Sprague right behind him. Back with more at the Orleans 250 right after this. Well, if you're just joining us, let's get you caught up to speed at what's happening in round 22 of the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. Early for Randy Renfro, qualified fourth, but they forgot to put the radio in. So under NASCAR rules, he had to bring it in. John Young tags the wall, our first of two cautions so far. Then you want to talk about some exciting racing. How about three abreast for the lead? It would be Jack Sprague after this lap. Then we're on board with Andy Houston. He gets it sideways, almost saves it until Ruttman comes in and boom, tags him right there. Then it was Ron Hornaday for the third lead change, going around his old nemesis, Jack Sprague. And guess what happened? Just while we were in commercial break, here is Jack Sprague, our fourth lead change, taking it back from Ron Hornaday. And now you're up to speed.
And there you see the leader, Jack Sprague, as he comes off turn four. Comes by to complete, get another lap. And we see Mike Stefanik, the Carlin Boilers, Ford, slow on the backstretch. Is he going to make it to pit road?
Tough break for Stefanik. He made his debut in the Craftsman Truck Series here last year and finished a very strong eighth. And it has been a frustrating campaign so far. This is the first truck that the new crew chief Roland Wolodica has basically rebuilt. But it looks like they've got some kind of mechanical problem that has knocked the Carlin burners and controls Ford to pit lane. And I don't know, Benny, he is still in turn three as we go back on board with Andy Houston. Now, he came into the pit stop earlier in the race. Dave, give us an update.
Actually, he just came in a couple of laps ago as the caution comes out, Marty. He came in because they had obviously had that contact, but he never came in. He had lost two laps already, so they decided to bring Andy in. They changed four tires and put on five huge patches of tape. Now, Randy Tolsma also came in while we were away, and Randy took on two right side tires and filled the truck full of fuel, but he does not have second or third gear. He's only running first and fourth.
Here he comes, trying to get a lap back on the leader of Ron Hornaday. Cannot quite make it. Hornaday has passed Jack Sprague to retake the lead. He might have done that on the caution flag.
Yeah, we're going to have to wait to see how NASCAR sorts it all out. Our third caution. We only had five cautions last year, and that's the record for the fewest. And here is the reason. Mike Stefanik still coasting, but he has not made it to the pit entry. He's about halfway between turns three and four.
Now, normally when the pace truck takes the field by the entrance to pit road, they would open the lane, pit road lane, so that we'd see trucks making pit stops. But now, with the record and the race truck on pit road, I doubt very seriously that pit road will be open. No, it's not, so the trucks will not be able to pit this lap.
We're under yellow third time pit stops. Let's go down to pit lane. Dave?
Marty, the 16 truck of Ron Hornaday, they're just going to remove a piece of tape on the front for a little more downforce and change right side tires. Now, let's go to Amy East.
Dennis Setzer has come in 10th and has a bad loose truck. He's going to take on right sides with 1 pound of air pressure up, a half a rubber out, and four turns down on the track bar, and hope that that makes him a lot tighter.
So we'll see who shakes out. Jack Sprague was shown as the official leader by NASCAR, and it looks like as they come back out onto the racetrack, and Sprague's already out onto the apron.
Well, you can go out on the apron, or you can use the safety road around the bottom of the racetrack. These two guys have chosen to use the racetrack where all the rest of the trucks stayed on the safety lane on the infield.
Dave, let's get an update on what happened with Jack Sprague.
By the way, guys, they argued to put the 24 back in front of the 16 and won that argument, so he preceded Ron Hornaday onto pit road. Then they took on two right side tires. They made an air pressure adjustment and put in a round of bite in the 24 truck because it was a bit loose.
Well, we show 14 trucks on the lead lap right now. We're in our third caution. As I mentioned a little bit earlier, last year we only had five. The record, and believe me, we don't want to come close to this, is nine. It was set back in 1996. And so far we have had a total of five lead changes. And last year we had a total of 14, so we're on a good pace there. We've had a lot of action so far, especially all the way back through the top 15 positions. There is Joe Ruttman. He's had a lot of action, and all of it's been the wrong kind.
Yes, he's right now. Ruttman, the Dana Dodge, is shown in 30th position. He's eight laps down. We see Andy Houston back in the pit area in the Cat Rental Chevrolet. See the damage to his truck. He's in 27th. He's four laps down, and they're trying to put some tape on the thing so that trying to block the nose up, aren't they, Dave?
They sure are, Benny. And you also see they're checking out the left front and trying to fix the toe. That's crew chief Rick Wren, who is on the tire. And underneath, Greg Tester is trying to get under there so he can free up some more of the material that's caught against it. And they're also going to drill through the hood and try to get that thing tied down better. So they've been making tape patches. Fans may wonder why he didn't come in early on. They were making tape patches. They didn't have any ready, obviously. And so they wanted to make a few before they got Andy. And he's going to get back out and live with what they've got.
He'd be great if it was Halloween weekend. That baby would be ready to go out trick-or-treating. Yeah, I hope it does the job for him because it looks awful.
It's not very pretty, you're right. As a matter of fact, it's ugly.
Let's take a look at the pit summary. Hornaday came in first, goes out second. Sprague has the lead. Bliss goes from third to fourth. Biffle picks up third, and Compton drops a position to sixth. Wallace comes out in fifth. Team ASC doing its good job as usual. Hensley holds station in seventh. Sauter drops way back to 12th. Crawford jumps up to eighth. And Dennis Setzer picked up a spot tonight. So Jay Sauter, the real big loser there.
All right, lights out atop the safety truck. This field is just about ready to go back to green flag racing. Two abreast, two rows. Cars on the inside. The seventh car lap down. The 24 Sprague, the leader.
Green flag,
green flag. Green flag is out.
So we are back to racing. after we have completed 58 of 167 laps. Jack Sprague is your leader. Here we go. Three wide. Hold on, guys. Sun is almost down in the west. Still playing havoc with our one camera in turn number two. Down the back straightaway. There is Marty Houston. They are going past Rick McRae. He is slowing dramatically in the Lucas Chevrolet right there in the middle of that pack. And meanwhile, up front.
Oh!
Whoa, Biffle!
Almost got the wall as he came off turn four.
So there's your top three, Sprague, Hornaday, and Greg Biffle.
Mike Wallace was able to get by Mike Bliss on the restart and move into the fourth position. And right now we've got a truck crash, and it's Bliss.
Bliss hard into the wall in turn two. I don't know if he got any help going around or if he just got turned around.
I see Mike Bliss moving in the truck, which is a good thing. But the damage of that truck is definitely not a good thing.
Bliss, our winner back at Heartland Park, Topeka. Last time out at Richmond, a disappointing 13th. And the X-Side Ford is up against the wall, and we are now in our fourth caution.
Check it. The right rear tire is blown. See this right rear tire, folks? All the damage around it. See here these little blisters? The tire has gone down. He had a flat tire and blew it down in turn one. That's what caused this thing to spin around.
Let's take a look at what happened. There he is in the middle.
All these trucks going by on the outside. And right there we see the right rear tire. I thought I saw it start to come apart. But we see the tire is, it starts smoking. It's flat. And around he goes. And bam. The outside retaining wall.
And that's why you're the professor. There's brand new tires from a report from Dave Burns on the right side. So a tough break for Mike Bliss. Obviously must have run over something. Cut it. His race is over. This is a third year in a row where he has started second. Last year he finished sixth. In 97 he finished fifth. He's led here well over with this year, well over 160 laps, but his race is done now. While the Cougars continue to work up in turn two, we're going to get pit stops. We'll give you the triple box. Sprague on top, Hornaday in the middle, Greg Biffle, the points leader, on the bottom. Dave?
Well, everyone's going to go to the left side because they went to the right side the first time. For Greg Biffle, when they put on right sides, they took a pound of air pressure out of each right side tire to try to tighten the truck up. This time, left sides will go on. A piece of tape off the grill. Biffle's out of here, Sprague's out of here, and the two of Wallace beats the 16 of Hornaday.
Well, Sprague with a 9.9-second stop, that's pretty phenomenal.
That was terrific. And look at Hornaday, 10.8, and Mike Bliss beat him out in the team ASC. So he had to have must have had a terrific pit stop.
Well, Wallace's crew has been giving him great position.
He's about to go green flag racing. 14, Rick Crawford, the circle bar Ford, was the leader. He chose to make a pit stop and relinquish the lead to...
I think it's going to be Jack Sprague shown as the race lead, although he is logged in behind the 41 of Randy Renfro, and Renfro is at least one lap down.
Base truck's off.
But see, Renfro's on the tail end of the lead lap, so thinks that qualifies him to be up there in front of Jack Sprague, and according to the rules, he can.
That's true. You're absolutely right, BP. He stayed out.
Green flag.
So he is on the tail end. So the third truck in line is your actual race leader on the left-hand side of your screen, the 24 of Jack Sprague. We restarted on lap 65 of 167. So far, we've had seven lead changes among four different drivers.
Ron Hornaday on the outside of Jack Sprague, and we see the 41 and 18 almost making contact. And Mike Wallace drives on the inside of Biffle to take a spot away, and Biffle on the inside of Sprague, and here comes Jimmy Isley. What a battle.
Coming down three abreast again. There is, well, on the apron, Sprague has to take it all the way down. He falls back in behind Biffle. There's Wallace in the two. Here comes Hensley on the outside. We go on board. Hornaday out front. Then Look for Renfro there. He's a lap down now in the 41. There is Wallace, the blue and white. And here comes Whipple underneath. Look out. This is a recipe for disaster.
Outside.
Yes.
And that was Ross Thompson, the 92 truck.
Outside.
GoRacing.com that made contact with the outside retaining wall.
We'll stay under green flag conditions. Thompson stays out on the racetrack. He seems to be under power, has dropped a few spots back. Meanwhile, Biffle has got a handful going down the back straightaway with Jack Sprague right on his back bumper. On the outside, the number two of Mike Wallace. Aldis.
Look at Wallace is driving on the outside, and the three abreast coming off four.
Hang on. Whoa, Biffle almost lost it for a second. Made a nice recovery. He's got a little bit of contact there with the 24 Sprague. Look at Hensley trying to squeeze in there as well. I don't know about you, Benny. I got goosebumps.
Man, this is something else.
Lap after lap here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. We're on board with Jack Sprague. Remember, we're going over 150 mile an hour average, folks. This is a mile and a half layout. We're not talking short track here. Wallace has sort of settled things down a little bit, at least for the moment. Oh, just as I say that, we got some contact between Biffle and Sprague again.
Well, Biffle started to turn left, get on the inside of Randy Renfro, but Jack Sprague was already there.
Inside. Inside.
That is Biffle's
inside.
Radio, Max Jones, spotting for
inside.
Him.
Inside.
And the worst thing he wants to hear right now is he's got trucks inside. Here comes Jay Sauter. He has worked his way up into this mix as well. Right alongside of Jimmy Hensley, we're on board with Stacy Compton.
And here comes the one truck of Dennis Setzer, trying to take that position away from our pole sitter, Stacy Compton. It's a battle for the eighth position. And finally, Biffle's able to clear himself of Randy Renfro.
Renfro is a lap down. Sauter now trying to get underneath Renfro. Sauter's team has won one tribute already this weekend. Kirk Bowman was awarded the Craftsman Truck Drivers Association Transporter Driver of the Year. So congratulations to the three team on that award.
The battle continues between Stacy Compton, the RC Dodge, and the Mopar Dodge of Dennis Setzer. Got a bunch of Dodges right there. Jimmy Hensley in the Petty Dodge.
Back to Mike Wallace as he has gotten around the lap traffic of Joe Ruttman. Wallace currently shown in second position. We've completed 70 laps. Amy?
Let's not forget Mike Wallace qualified 13th, but the Ultra Bad Boys always gain him track position. Put that together with Tim Kahoot's awesome super speedway knowledge. Let's throw Tim Brewer into the mix. He's down here helping Mike Wallace get yet another super speedway win. And right now, he's showing to be very, very strong.
Remember that Wallace won back at Homestead and Pikes Peak. Jack Sprague is trying to close in on it. That is Biffle, the third truck in that line right there. That is second, third, and
oh, me! Jack Sprague almost spun out going in turn three. What a terrific job he saved that GMAC Chevrolet.
The action never stops here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. 95 laps to go. These guys are driving it like it's the last two laps of the race. Right up on the back bumper, that's the margin.
And that does not help the loose condition that Jack Sprague seems to be experiencing right now.
On board with Greg Biffle. We've got to take a break. Don't go away. We've got an exciting race going on here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway at the Orleans 250. For fourth here at the Orleans 250 at Las Vegas Motor Speedway, Mike Wallace has it, but he may be in some trouble, BP, because Sauter got around him momentarily.
But Mike Wallace passed him right back. So here they come by the start-finish line to complete yet another lap. And right now they are about 2 miles per hour slower than the leader of Ron Hornaday.
Take a look at the Super Speedway career win chart. Jack Sprague, your all-time leader with 9. Ron Hornaday, 7. And the guys with the marks, that's victories that all came here in 1999. Biffle has 4. Dennis Setzer, Mike Wallace, two apiece. All three of those guys are currently running in the top five as well, and so is Sprague and Hornaday. Back to this battle. Mike Wallace, you know, in the last 10 races, I don't know if this says how bad his qualifying is. He's finished better than he has qualified in the last 10 races. Back up front to our race leader, that's Ron Hornaday. Dave, you got something up on the guys running up front?
Well, as much as these guys have battled over the years and touched fenders, they're trying to cooperate tonight. In fact, Steve Meehl just talked with Dennis Conner, and they worked out a little bit of a deal for the moment. Now, Sprague isn't anywhere near Hornaday right now, but he said, if you'll just not mess with us, let's let the 16 or the 24 try to pull away from everybody else. Now, of course, that strategy is also only good for a time. These trucks are going to have to pit between laps 110 and 120 for the final time for fuel and, of course, tires. So it's a deal for now. Right now, these guys are friends.
Yeah. You know what, BP? You and I have been around those two too long. Meehl and Conner may cut the deal, but when it comes crunch time, they admit it. It's like they see the red mark, and the red mist just comes over their eyes when they are running with each other.
That's true. But right now, Jack Sprague, well, he did not lose any. The last two or three laps, he's been losing ground to Ron Hornaday. Maybe that was the plan. Maybe that they have decided, okay, we're going to let Hornaday lead this thing. I'll just sit back here and ride. But meanwhile, here comes Greg Biffle up to challenge. Biffle right now is only about a second and a half behind the second-place car of Jack Sprague. As we see, Jay saw the Goodman truck trying to get by Mike Wallace once again.
He makes a look underneath, but he can't get the job done. Wallace holds on to the position for one more lap. 77 laps to go here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. On board with Mike Wallace. Hearing feather in that throttle a little bit. Sun is setting. That means track temperature is changing. Moving back towards Dennis Setzer, who is in sixth position. He started in ninth. I asked Dennis, I said, you know, obviously Biffle's got the largest lead ever with four races remaining of 125 points. Is there anything you can do to stop him? He says, not really. He says, we just have to go drive our race. We have to try and win and hope that he runs into some kind of problem.
And that's just been very difficult to find, is Biffle and those guys having some kind of problem, because Biffle has done a good job driving the truck, but Randy Goss and his guys have done a terrific job preparing the truck, getting it mechanically sound.
You know, Setzer is one of four guys in the current top five in the championship chase that have never finished among the top five in the point standings prior. So we're definitely seeing a changing of the guard. And here's one of those guys, Stacy Compton. Biffle, Setzer, Compton, and Mike Wallace are those guys.
Stacy Compton is on the same serial as everyone else, according to pit stops. Right side tires the first time, then left side tires. The problem right now is that he's loose off the corners, and he's tight in the middle. They're not sure what they're going to do to adjust it the next time he comes in. But if they do wait those 50 or 60 laps to come in, they're going to have a problem that everyone seems to be experiencing up and down pit road. That's just about as long as the tires are lasting tonight. They're lasting, but there's about nothing left on them. That's the report I'm getting up and down pit road. So it's a good tire, but it's really only lasting about 60 laps.
Jimmy Hensley is also coming up through this pack. You see him there running in eighth place, right behind Stacy Compton. Hensley started 10th and has been in the mix since the get-go.
Jimmy Hensley, as you said earlier, another driver that's trying to add to his resume for the year 2000, looking for a ride. Richard Petty has told Jimmy that he will not be back in this Dodge next year.
Yeah. You saw Jimmy's best finish the last year here at third. In 97, he was 15th. In 96, he was 17th. So he's had mixed results. Ron Hornaday, meanwhile, up front by 1.65 seconds. And he's been okay at this track, of course, finishing second last year here and winning the championship. And in 97, between he and the GMAC Chevrolet of Jack Sprague. In fact, let's show you a little bit what happened during the break.
Check this out. Right on the inside, coming off turn two, down on the apron of the racetrack, trying to get inside, but he gets a little loose when he comes off the corner. I'm talking about the 50 truck of Biffle, has to back off the gas when he does that. Sprague on the gas, tries to take the lead, but Biffle goes at three, takes the lead. Now Jack Sprague comes up right on the back bumper. He wants to get Biffle loose. He wants to say, you're going to play games? Now watch this down the straightaway. Biffle goes down the exhaust, bottoms out on the apron of the racetrack as he's trying to break the draft on Jack Sprague.
And Randy Goss on the radio said, I don't think you should do that again. Back to the live action. Taking a look at the Dodge race recap, our current leader is Ron Hornaday. We have had 9 lead changes between 4 different drivers. Hornaday has led most of the laps so far, 49 of 99. We've had 4 cautions. The record is 9. We don't want to come anywhere close to that. Average race speed is underneath our record of 130 miles an hour set last year by the guy you're looking at, Jack Sprague. So you're caught up to date there. You get the idea of who's led the most laps. Sprague is second in the count. Mike Bliss, whoa, and Benny, he's loose.
Jack Sprague is really, really loose in that Goodrich in that GMAC Chevrolet. But he's trying, he is driving as hard as he possibly can because he knows he can't let these guys get away from him.
Well, remember, Sprague has given up on this championship hunt. He's only 125 points behind Biffle. Dave?
I just spoke with Dennis Conner, and they confirm they're they don't need to confirm, do they, Betty? They are loose, and they say they want to make an adjustment in the right rear. They want to take a spring rubber out the next time he comes in and definitely try to tighten up that truck.
Well, Sprague owns the Craftsman Truck Series record for 5 Super Speedway wins in a single season. He also has 12 career poles on the Super Speedway. That's another record. Look at the speeds here. Still well up over 150 mile an hour average.
Underneath your wing.
Sprague in that GMAC, he is driving as hard as anyone you'll ever see drive because right now he just doesn't have the truck to keep up with the Greg Biffle truck, but he's doing it by sheer determination.
Did you see Biffle give him a little wiggle there trying to break up the wind? Here we go.
Inside.
Sprague may be loose, but he is coming on strong. And can he take the position? This is the same thing we had happening last year near the end of the race.
Inside, you're clear.
Couldn't get the job done, though. Biffle holds on.
He's trying to frustrate you. That's all he's got left, Greg.
Randy Goss telling his driver he's just trying to frustrate you.
And I would guess he's doing a pretty good job of it right now.
Right on your wing. Right on your wing.
Max Jones telling him he's on your wing.
On your wing.
And at these speeds, it's easy to take some of that wind off of there, loosen you up. Oof, got awfully close to the wall. Sprague back onto the throttle.
Now, looks like that it has worked because it looks like the Biffle's truck right now starting to get loose. Oh, man.
While all this action is going on, we can tell you that Hornaday's lead is now 2.5 seconds over these two guys because they're beating on each other. Take a look at the fast last laps. Biffle at 151, 2.8, just a touch quicker than Ron Hornaday. We're going to take another commercial break. All the action going on, we promise. If anything happens, we'll record it for you. Riding along with our race leader, Ron Hornaday. You can barely see his head. Is shot right on the front hood. And a little bit earlier, we had some contact. BP, take us through it.
Well, now that's a real shock that these two trucks would get into each other. Look at that. Boom. Down the back stretch, going in turn 3. Sprague says, okay, maybe I've knocked him up out of the way. I'll try to get on the inside. Didn't work. Biffle still holds that second spot.
And the question, obviously, that we can't answer was, did Biffle get out of the throttle early, or did Sprague not get on the brake soon enough? But no harm. Both trucks still running in lockstep.
Lots of traffic up ahead.
And that's exactly right. I was going to say the same thing. A lot of traffic up in front of these two trucks.
That's inside. It. Inside.
And here's some pretty serious traffic to the Ford truck. Austin Cameron and almost contact between he and the one of Dennis Setzer.
Cameron is lap traffic, and that's the battle between 5th and 6th place between Mike Wallace and Dennis Setzer. Setzer had a run, but he had to get out of it. And now he's closing back up on Mike Wallace.
Chase Sauter's pulled out about a second ahead of Mike Wallace.
In fact, let's set the top 5 for you. It's Ron Hornaday first, Jack Sprague second, Greg Biffle third, Jay Sauter in fourth. Mike Wallace there in fifth. And there's that smoke, Benny, that you mentioned. There is smoke from the number two team, ASE Ford. Mike Wallace in fifth place. Dennis Setzer right behind him obviously saw that smoke. And there it is again. Amy, you got an update?
Well, from the smell down here on pit lane, they are speculating at this point that that is rear end grease that they are smelling down here, and that may be the smoke coming from Mike Wallace's truck. But they did think it was engine trouble at first, but he proved that he can run with the three and that it's not engine trouble. Tim Kahuth has decided that it's time to bring the truck down pit lane. Let's find out for sure so that we can fix it and try to get back out there.
It's getting worse, BP.
It is getting worse. And we see here Sprague on the outside of Biffle.
This is a battle for second.
Oh, contact.
Outside, you're clear.
Oh.
Clear.
Man, how did that work?
I think because we inhaled, it drew that 50 truck just in far enough.
Outside.
Because that's
outside.
How close it looked like
outside.
From here. And now
outside.
They're going under Ross Thompson.
Outside. Clear.
Jones, put your mic close to your mouth.
Here we are still on this battle with Biffle holding off Jack Sprague. We've got 53 laps to go. Ron Hornaday, by the way, does pick up the $1,000 Gatorade money for leading halfway. Down the back straightaway. Let's go on board with Jack Sprague. Can he get the job done this time, BP?
Well, there's a slow truck right in front of Mike Cope. The man I'm auto auctions truck right in front of Cope. Save that, baby. Okay, that's a good boy. Damn, I thought Cope was going to be in trouble there for a second. Meanwhile, now that Sprague is going to try it again.
Boy, how did he get the run? He had to back out of it. Now he's coming underneath Biffle one more time.
Still in there. Still in there.
And now you got slower traffic again. That's going to be Michael Dawkins in the 7. He pulls way down on the apron and lets these guys go blowing by. Side by side down the backstretch.
That's right.
Biffle. And Sprague, this has been just going on for lap after lap. These guys are going after each other. Hornaday's lead now is 2.8 seconds.
And neither one of these guys will say uncle. Neither one will cry uncle.
First and second in the championship points chase.
We need to let him go because we're going to pit.
Well, you heard Randy Goss say, let him go, we're going to pit.
We're within five, all right? We're watching Hornaday.
I don't think he got the message, Benny.
No, I don't think he heard him. They just will not give up. And Mike Wallace has been given the black flag from the Craftsman Truck Series official.
And he is on the race line down the back straightaway. Here comes Sprague loose again. Meanwhile, race leader Ron Hornaday peels off and pulls into the pit lane. So our round of green flag pit stops is about to begin. 55 miles an hour, and that's what it looks like on pit lane. And there is Biffle, your new race leader.
You're clear, you're clear.
But he also has a pit stop in his future.
Get this lap for four, Greg.
Remember, under green flag, you can get four tires. Dave?
Leader Ron Hornaday is in, but he has a big complaint. There's a huge vibration in the Napa Auto Parts Chevrolet. They don't know where it is. He thought maybe he had lost a cylinder, but then it kept running, and his times were great. Two right side tires for Hornaday. Let's go to Amy.
There is a lot of smoke down here in the Ultra Wheels pit. They're going to go ahead and take on the four tires. They don't really seem like they're doing much about the smoke, although they did motion for the fire crew to come over here just as a precaution. Tim Kahuth is talking to his crew. The NASCAR officials have now told them, kill the motor, and let's pull up the hood and see what's going on. Dave Burns.
Jack Sprague comes in very close to pit wall. They go to the right side. They're going to change him as well, and they're going to try to put right sides on and take out that spring rubber in the rear. Greg Biffle will also take on right side tires in the 50 truck, and they will go up and try to no adjustments on Biffle. They report they were not going to have any adjustments on Greg Biffle, and it looks like 15.7 on Sprague. He's out of here, and Greg Biffle's going to take on four. Four tires for Biffle now to the left side. He's down
clear.
And out of here.
You're clear.
All right, now which strategy is going to be the better one, Ben? Because of our three top leaders, Biffle's the only one who took four.
But Greg Biffle is the guy that's trying his best to win a championship. That was a championship move. That was trying to win the race. That was trying to win a championship. A good move on the part of Randy Goss and all the guys that make the choices. decisions in the Greg Biffle pits.
Jay Sauter, your race leader right now, cycling through. He is pulling into pit lane, and you make the entry into pit lane on turn three. You get a penalty if you dive off after turn four, and you got to get it down to 55 miles an hour. So the Goodrich Chevrolet will come in, and he makes his way towards the pit box. Now the question will be, will they do two or will they go for four? My guess, and BP, I think you're dead spot on, they're going to just do the two, get the full load of fuel, and get back out because they want to win the race. Right rear a little bit slow. In fact, fuel the last part, and he is back out underway. So two rights for the Goodrich Chevy of Jay Sauter.
I think most of these trucks that's pit now will change right side tires, but once again, Greg Biffle trying to win a championship. He has a 125-point lead, and he comes back on the racetrack. He's only one car between himself and Jack Sprague. Great strategy.
Biffle, we're on board. He is in eighth place right now. Your current race leader, well, that belongs to Jimmy Hensley. He has taken the lead here at the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. Stops have cycled through here at the Orleans 250. You're on board with the race leader, Ron Hornaday. Jack Sprague is now shown in second place. As of right now, Jimmy Hensley is shown in third, but he has made a pit stop, so the cycle will continue. That will move Greg Biffle back into the third spot. And right now, Benny, last lap, Sprague or Hornaday ran about 154, but Biffle ran 156.
And folks, if you wonder what this piece is right there, that's a hood hinge. When they raise the hood on this truck, that's the hinge that we're seeing.
Yeah, just looks a little bit bigger because of the proximity of the onboard camera system. Amy, Mike Wallace is out of this race. Is that what we're hearing?
Out of this race and extremely disappointed after the tough truck that he had. Mike, what was it? Did the engine just let go?
Well, yeah, something in the motor is broken. It's pumping oil out. You know, it's pumping everything's in the oil tank out the motor. And it's a shame. Team ASE truck was running real good. You know, as a Ford F-150 was handling better as the cooler it got. But thought we had something for him on the restart. You know, Hornaday and our, the whole group of us were racing there. And then it laid down about 5-10 laps later and just started running slower and slower. And kind of started smoking a lot. So it's a shame, but I guess that's the way it goes.
Our race leader is Ron Hornaday. But the point we've got to make is the guy in third, Greg Biffle, is closing at 1.1 seconds a lap.
You know, I thought that it was a championship decision to change four tires, but what a great decision it's been as far as trying to win the race is concerned. Greg Biffle right now is only a little over 5 seconds behind the leader, Ron Hornaday, and as you said, picking up about a second a lap. So there shouldn't be any reason he has 36 laps to go, 35 laps to go. He might be able to catch Hornaday and take the lead away.
Hornaday just crossed the stripe with 35 now to go, and we'll find out. Biffle has cut the margin down to 4.8 seconds.
It looks like he is going to catch Ron Hornaday. He's only right now about 1 second behind the 24 truck of Jack Sprague.
And you want to talk about close finishes here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway? Well, two of the three previous finishes have been less second at the stripe. That is Kevin Harvick side by side with Jack Sprague.
And look who comes in the picture.
Biffle is closing rapidly. Randy Tolsma in the 25.
Kevin Harvick goes up the hill with those worn tires. He has to slide up the hill. And here comes Biffle. He has the 24 truck right in front of him. And there's nothing this time that Sprague can do. He cannot keep it back when he changed two tires and Biffle has the four.
Tolsma currently running in 17th position, getting around Kevin Harvick. And here comes Biffle closing rapidly on Jack Sprague.
Down in turn one, Sprague goes to the inside as he goes up the hill. Watch Biffle just blow right by to take second spot away.
Dave, what's happening on the 24 truck?
Well, Marty, Benny mentioned championship decisions, and the 1997 champion, Jack Sprague, and his crew chief, Dennis Conner, had the same idea, four tires. But remember when Jack pulled into the pits and I said, look how close to the wall he is? They never could have gotten those other two on, and they could only take on rights.
Ah, could not get the jack under the car and be able to pump the car because the handle would be hitting the pit wall.
So Jack Sprague may be kicking himself by the end of this one, because right now Biffle is past him. And take a look at the interval. Back at lap 129, it was 6.6 seconds. And now it's 4.4 seconds.
That's just amazing how fast the Granger truck is right now.
Remember also, if Ford finishes in front of
seven
Chevrolet,
guys on the lead lap,
they
seven
win
guys.
The manufacturer's championship.
So I think the 24 and the 16 could come for left once more. Clear on the bottom.
That's
they
Randy
could come
Goss.
For left once more, but I don't think their truck would be right.
That's Randy Goss telling his driver they may come for lefts, but I don't think Randy's got any ideas of stopping right now. The 50's on rails.
No, he's not going to stop. He said if the caution flag comes out, that those there's only seven trucks now on the lead lap. Eight trucks, actually. Rick Crawford, the last truck on the lead lap. Well, seven, because Crawford now is, in fact, a lap down. If the caution flag comes out, those guys in front will come in and change left sides. But Randy's saying it will not match up. And the caution flag, as we're talking about it, the caution flag is out.
Trying to find out what the problem is. Turn four, we've got a report of an exhaust pipe that has fallen off one of the trucks. So that's the word. We are under our fifth caution of the evening. You're looking at the race leader. That's right. During the commercial break, we're under caution, our fifth of the evening. Greg Biffle inherited the lead because, Benny, just as you suspected, everybody who had changed just two tires went in and change that left side.
Change left sides. Now, here we see the triple pit. There's the leader, Ron Hornaday, the Napa Auto Parts Chevrolet. The 24 truck, Sprague, is in second. The one truck of Dennis Setzer was running fourth place. See, Hornaday stops. And I think Hornaday gets a little bit too close to pit wall. Watch the jack go up. See, you're supposed to do that with one pump. It was about five pumps, and just that little bit cost him about a second or two in the pits. We see Ron Hornaday down at 10.7. Check out Sprague, 9.5. He takes second spot away from Ron Hornaday.
Now remember, they're not going to lose all that much track position because we've only got nine trucks on the lead lap, so they'll be at the back of that shorter line. We've had 15 lead changes now, and that is a new record for Las Vegas. Let's get an update on Jack Sprague. David?
Well, a bit ago, Marty, you remember I reported that they were going to take a spring rubber out of the right rear to try to tighten the truck up. They did that on the last set of pit stops, but it was still loose. So this time they made a wedge adjustment in addition to changing left side tires. And that combination, boy, if that doesn't tighten that truck up, I don't know what will.
On board with Jack Sprague as he is back out on the track. Just gone back to green flag racing here. We've completed laps 142. Of 167, Greg Biffle is the race leader. Jack Sprague is in second. Ron Hornaday is third. And there you can see the top three trying to duke it out. And look at the battle back for fourth. That is Sauter and Setzer. Sauter in the three Goodwrench Chevrolet on the low side, on board with Stacy Compton, who is looking from sixth position at that battle.
On board with the RC Cola. Oh! Setzer's in the wall up turn two.
Might have a little more debris on the racetrack. That was the reason we had our fifth caution.
But Setzer did not even back off the throttle when he touched the wall over there, still on the outside of Jay Sauter.
Well, we've seen him do that a couple of times before this race season. He'll stay in that hammer. Here we go again. Ugh, got close. Setzer does not want to give up the spot. Amy, you got more?
Well, Benny, let's pose this question. What's better, left sides or right sides? The three took on lefts on that last stop, and the one took on rights. They're side by side. Let's see which truck has got the stronger compound right now.
Compton right there. There's Jimmy Hensley as well. There's the move back up front. You can see the margin. Biffle. Even though he's got a few extra laps on those left sides, it looks like he's holding his own. Let's talk about the strategy. David, you got something more?
Greg Biffle didn't pit last time, Marty, because they were out of ammunition. Remember, in the Craftsman Truck Series, you only get 16 tires for the weekend. They practiced on four. Those were no good. You start the race with 12. Four on the truck. They've made four two-tire pit stops. They had no more fresh tires to put on the 50 truck. Tire specialist Tony Lunders has selected the best ones he can find just in case they have a problem, but they didn't have anything more to throw at the Granger Ford.
And we see Bragg trying to dive to the inside. You see now Jack Sprague in the 16 truck, they only had left side to put on. They don't have any more right sides to put on. They only have
21
left
to go,
side.
21.
You heard Randy Goss tell Greg Biffle, 21 laps to go. So from this point on, it's up to the drivers. You have to conserve what tires you have on your truck. You got to be able to make them last. Oh, gee, but Biffle looked awfully close to the wall. Let's find out who's quickest at the line.
Rex in four. Wave him off. Wave him off. Wave him off. He's inside.
Got a yellow, and boy, oh, Scott Hansen has hit the wall hard. Turn number four. The Oakwood home Chevrolet.
We heard Max Jones telling his driver, Greg Biffle, to wave off Jack Sprague because the caution flag was out. But barely. I mean, he had his bell rung awfully hard up in turns three and four. That was a tremendous impact with the wall.
Upper right-hand corner of your screen, boom, right there.
Man, oh, man. Have no idea what might have caused that collision with the wall, but you see this truck, it doesn't stop because Hansen puts on the brakes or anything else. It stops because it gets tired of rolling.
The friction with the wall is what brings him to a stop all the way into turn four.
Because right now, Scott Hansen is like that steering wheel. He is just a passenger in that truck.
On board with our leader, that is Greg Biffle. Let's go down to Randy Goss. He's with Dave Burns.
And he is a crew chief for Greg Biffle. And Randy, you guys changed four and then found that Sprague was able to come back in a little later and put on the lefts. Did you think maybe that he had an advantage?
Well, I was thinking he might have the advantage. We put four on. When the race is over, they'll have 48 laps on them. And we thought we could hit our chassis setup better putting four on at the same time versus putting two on later. And if it would have been a long green flag, we would have run out of left side tires anyways.
Now, the truck has had about 20 laps on it or so at this point with those tires on it. How good is it?
I think it's pretty good. I can never tell with him anymore.
Oh, why is that?
What he's got left, you know.
You think he saves it on you even?
Looks like Sprague's got something for us right now, but they were lobbying for some rights, so maybe they're in trouble. I don't know.
Okay, that's the word from Randy Goss, and Biffle continues to lead this thing with Sprague hot on his heels, and that's the championship battle, guys.
Well, and let's point out one other thing. Greg Biffle wins this race. That would be number 9 for the year, and that would be a new NASCAR Craftsman Truck single-season record. Mike Skinner holds the mark. In fact, he's tied with Biffle at 8. And Ford would win the Manufacturers Championship if Jack Sprague on board. He is running second. Of course, his history here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway is explicitly, well, it's just, look at it, 1.3 average. He's won 2 out of the 3 races, Ben.
Wow, that is pretty strong, 1.3. You don't see that much in him. Man, oh, man.
Yeah, and he's in striking distance for sure, running in second place right behind the Granger Ford. As the lights are out on the pace car, we are ready to go back to green flag racing here on lap number 153.
Green flag, green flag.
You heard the call. Fans are coming to their feet, and we're underway. 167 is the total that we're going. 14 to go.
And we see Kevin Harvick in the 98 truck up there trying to get a lap back on the inside of Biffle.
Harvick one lap down. He wants to stay on that lead lap if he can. Doesn't look like it's going to happen tonight.
Biffle goes by, and here comes Jack Sprague closing in on the back bumper.
Remember last year, Greg Biffle had the race lead. Jack Sprague needed to get it because he needed to win and to have a chance at winning the championship. Obviously, last year here at Las Vegas was the final race of the season. It's not the final race this year, but when Greg Biffle holds a 125-point lead, this is very important.
And Ron Hornaday just doesn't seem to have the muscle right now in that Napa Chevrolet that he had so earlier on. Remember, he led the most laps here tonight and seemed to pull away from these two trucks, but right now seems to be struggling to keep up.
Sprague measuring Biffle. Does he have anything left for him? 13 laps to go. Biffle likes that high entry into turn one. Whoop, getting a little twitchy.
Getting a little bit, you're right.
34-7. It's Sprague behind you, then the 98, then the 16.
Giving him the lap time, also telling him who is behind you. Right now, he only has to worry about one truck, and that's the 24, Jack Sprague. Woof, man, he is getting so close to that wall, Ben. Let's go back to the line and find out who's quickest. This time by, looks like it's going to be Mr. Biffle. Look at Jimmy Hensley, third quickest. Back there in eighth position.
And Jimmy Hensley stopped on this last caution flag and made a pit stop and obviously made a chassis adjustment. That's allowed him to run a little bit better.
34-7, the last lap time. You heard Randy Goss tell his driver on the radio. You're right. Ron Hornaday doesn't have anything for these two guys right now, Benny.
Sure doesn't seem like it.
Here we go one more time at the line. Biffle at 155.2. But look who is quickest this time. Dennis Setzer at 155.5. Back in fourth position.
I'll give her all she's got, baby. Come on, Springster.
34.8.
Stay focused, Greg. Stay focused. You have 10 to go when you go by this time.
But Sprague is not going. He just will not give up.
I love listening to all these guys talking to their drivers.
He drafts you right here, Greg.
Talking about the draft at the line again. This time Sprague's quicker and Setzer second quick.
He's right under your wing.
It seems like when Sprague gets close to the Granger 40, gets him loose.
Jack Sprague.
Outside, outside.
Oh, man,
outside.
Tries the outside pass, Benny. Here we go. Can he hold it? Oh, mercy.
Contact. Got to be rubbing. They got to be rubbing.
Outside.
Side by side. Nine laps to go. You saw the donut on the left side door panel.
Outside.
Biffle holds him off.
Oh, man, oh, man. How did they not make contact? I got in one and two.
I think they did because it looked like the Granger 4 twitched just a little bit.
Bill Sprague got out of the opportunity.
Nine laps. It'll be eight this time by. What a great battle between these two competitors. First and second in the points. They're first and second on the racetrack.
And neither one of these guys will just give up. They will not say, I quit.
Biffle takes that high line again into one. Sprague right there. While those two were beating on each other, Ron Hornaday has closed in a little bit from his third position. There you see him. And Setzer's right behind him. Oh, this could get down to being four trucks to the finish.
And we see eight laps to go, seven when they cross the line this time.
All of a sudden, Sprague's got to start checking his mirror. His old nemesis is closing quickly. Hornaday in third. Biffle holds the low line. Sprague right there, waiting for a mistake, trying to take the air off his
head. That's your strength right there, leaving. That's your only strength down here.
Turn two is Greg Biffle's strong suit. We heard Randy Goss just sit right here.
Yellow's out.
The yellow flag is out.
Wave them off. It's like a muffler.
Seven laps.
Turn one, right in the middle of the track.
Yeah, right in the middle of turn one, you can see it. There's a muffler, a tailpipe, something. And all of a sudden, we're going to go yellow here. There you can see the debris. I can't make out exactly what it is. Look out, guys. Don't hit it. Bring it in close. Our seventh caution, the record is nine, and it looks like we may run a little long tonight.
And that's too bad, because I want to get back to the hotel in time to see Sports Center, see what happened to the Ryder Cup team today.
Well, you're going to get that chance at 11 o'clock Eastern tonight, BP. And also, let's let you know right now, because we're obviously going to be running long, our race winner interview will be seen tomorrow at 5 o'clock Eastern on RPM. So make sure you're tuned in to find out what happened here, and the eyes and the sounds, and oh man, look at Joe, it that right rear quarter panel.
Look at that thing just waving.
And
finally waved away and said, see ya. As you can see by the sparks, that is metal, so it had to get it off the racetrack.
And there is Joe Ruttman, and he's got a head for pit lane. Coming up next, it'll be the 50 greatest athletes. Martina Navratilova, number 19. 9 times she won Wimbledon. It's like winning Daytona, the 500, 9 times. Imagine how tough that can be. Number 19, coming up next, Martina Navratilova.
5 laps to go. The lights out atop the safety car. Green flag next time by on 163. 4 laps to go.
So it'll almost be like one of our shootouts with the green-white checker, but it'll be a 4-lap shootout. Dennis Conner, talk about nerves. He's been in this situation before. Last year, he and Ron Hornaday, and Hornaday right behind his driver again.
You wonder who's more nervous, these guys here in pit road or Jack Roush up in Dover, Delaware, getting ready for the NBNA 400 tomorrow, or Rick Hendrick back in Charlotte getting ready to watch his team compete Sunday afternoon.
Can Ron Hornaday pull off one of his patented restarts? Can Jack Sprague reel in the Granger Ford and deny Ford the Manufacturers Championship? And deny Greg Biffle his 9th record-setting win of 1999? Or will it be Greg Biffle in control, winning 7 of the last 12 races? Setting himself atop the points lead coming in tonight by 125.
You see, no slow trucks on the inside. 10 laps to go or less. These trucks will line up nose to tail. All the lead lap trucks.
Green flag.
Green flag flies. You heard Randy Goss make the call. Biffle gets a good start. What about Sprague and Hornaday and Setzer? So far, looks like Biffle in control. Through turn 2, and Benny, this is where the team says he's best.
It looks that way. It looks like 1 and 2 when he takes that high line, getting down in turn 1. He's able to run through the middle of the corner in 1 and 2 and get off 2 really well. But right here seems to be his problem. Here's where Sprague seems to close up on the back bumper, that Granger Ford.
It's Ford, Chevy, and a Dodge. That's your top 4. 3 laps to go this time by. A little bit higher off of turn 1 through 2, Benny.
That time he did not quite get down to the bottom of the racetrack like he needed to, although he still...
That was good. That was good for a truck length.
Down the back straightaway, Greg Biffle maintains the position. Hornaday can't seem to reel him in down the straightaway. He gets a little closer through the corner.
And then a Setzer's...
Don't go too much swerving. Not too high. That's good.
2 laps to go. Biffle takes the high line again into 1. You heard a not too much swerving. Is he worried about chewing up the tire?
Well, I'm not sure exactly.
Better than him leaving there.
Comes off 2 strong again. Has about a 3 truck length lead. This time by, it'll be the white flag. Last year, Las Vegas, Greg Biffle had the lead. Ended up in 5th spot. Sprague won the race. Hornaday won the championship. This time, Biffle's on his way to a championship. 1 more lap to go, 1.5 miles for victory number 9 in the record book.
If Biffle gets that same exit off turn 2, he should be able to hold him back.
Looking good, you're clear.
Absolutely, he is looking good. You roll the dice when you come to Las Vegas. Sometimes you come up snake eyes. Sometimes you hit 7 right on that first roll, and you take all the bank, all the money home. And here comes the record book
for
Greg Biffle. He wins round 22 and his 9th win, and Ford is your manufacturer's champion.
Good job. Inside.
The congratulations of this team, they have earned it. And Ford breaks Chevrolet's stranglehold of 4 straight manufacturers' champions as they take the manufacturer's crown. So your winner is Greg Biffle. Remember, RPM tonight, Ford Century coming up next, Martina Navratilova. For Benny, Dave, Amy, I'm Marty. We'll see you next time. Your winner is Greg Biffle. So long, everybody.